Hey everyone, it's Quoia, Renae, and I'm back with another video. So today's video is a little bit different. I am actually going to be taking this old sewing out. As you all can see, I got a lot of new growth, a lot of dandruff, honey. It's just a lot going on. So I'm going to take this seam ripper to help cut out the thread of my hair. You have to be careful with this seam ripper because instead of cutting the thread, you might make a mistake and cut your own hair. So you got to be careful. That's why I'm also going to use the end of a rat tail comb, and I am just going to use that to sort of lift the thread so I can make sure that I'm actually catching the thread and not catching my hair. And then once I know that it's the thread, I'm going to take the seam ripper and cut it just like that. And I'm just gonna keep that doing it. I'm gonna keep doing that all the way around. I don't use the seam ripper a lot during the time that I'm cutting my sewing out. I try to use either the comb to lift the thread so I can make sure that I'm not lifting my hair and cutting my hair. But definitely having that rat tail comb, the end part of that definitely helps in this process. I'm also making sure that even when I'm not recording a video, when I take my sewings out, I try to make sure that my room is well lit. I put my ring light right in front of me, or I'll use my vanity. My vanity mirror has a light on it as well. So using a mirror or some type of light also helps to make sure that you can see that thread, because you won't really be able to see black thread with black hair really. So you'll mess around and end up cutting your hair. So make sure your room is well lit and you'll be good. I usually keep my sew-ins in for about a month if I'm not being lazy. Otherwise, it stays in a lot longer if I just have a lot going on and I just don't get a chance to take it out. And I have like stuff coming up, like now I have stuff coming up that I want my hair done for. So I usually try to give my hair a break, y'all, in between sew-ins. I try to at least keep my natural hair out. I usually wear it in a puff. I like to wear it in a puff for about a month and wash my hair weekly, deep conditioning, just so I can put that moisture back in my hair. I try to do that in between sew-ins, but I'm actually going to give myself a protein treatment because I feel like my hair is in dire need of a protein treatment. I'm going to try to do the apple cider vinegar rinse so I can get rid of this dandruff and add some shine to my hair. And I think I'm going to show you all that in the next video. I think I'm going to upload that in probably a day or two. I'm just going to probably have a life update with y'all, have a little chat with y'all, and give myself a protein treatment. Oh my god, y'all, don't it feel so good when you're taking out sew-ins or quick weaves? Like, it just feel like some weight is being lifted off your head, honey. It just feels so good. It just feel like, even for some of y'all girls that wear wigs and frontals, I know it feels so good to finally snatch that thing off, honey. You can get a good, real good itch in, honey. Not itch, but scratch in, honey. Oh my god, it's the best. So finally I have reached my last track, honey. It just, oh my god, it just feels so good to, you know, reach my last track. So I'm just going to continue to use that same method with my rat tail comb, lifting the thread and using my fingers, and then using the seam ripper as needed, not just using it just to lift thread, but I'm using it when I need it, when I come into a knot. So once I have gotten that last bundle out, I have to take the net off. I sew on a net just so my sew-ins last longer, just in case, you know, situations like this when I have to keep it in longer than a month. I definitely want my hair to stay secure. A lot of you all always are asking me, how do you keep your hair dry and keeping it from molding and all of that good stuff? Well, my hair doesn't ever mold. I don't keep sew-ins in for years. I don't want my daggone hair to mold, but it definitely gets dandruff, and your hair is going to get dandruff if you have a dry scalp, and if you're not providing a lot of moisture to it, it's going to get dandruff. And that's what mine gets when I keep my sew-ins in for a long time. It get dandruff. And my hair gets dandruff even when I don't keep my sew-ins in. When I have my natural puff out, my hair, I just have a dry scalp. That's why I need to spend time with my hair, some quality time with my hair, moisturizing my scalp, because I have a really, really dry scalp. And once I put that net on it, I love the net, but it doesn't help to get moisture with the net. So if you don't have to use the net, don't use it. But I like to use it because it makes my sew-ins feel a lot more secure, and I can just pretty much sew anywhere I want to. I don't have to necessarily sew on top of the braid. I can sew on the net. So once I take the net off, I can get into these ancient braids. These braids so ancient, honey, got hella new growth, and that takes another hour. Y'all, it take about as long as to get a sew-in to take the sew-in out for me. For me, because I try to make sure that I'm not ripping my hair out. So I like to take my time. I don't be rushing that process, because if you're rushing your process, you're gonna mess around and rip your hair out, and it already is gonna be a lot of shedding anyways, because it's been in some braids underneath weave. So it's going to be a lot of shedding, and to prevent any other excess unnecessary shedding, I like to take my time with my hair. When I take down my braids, when I'm taking out the sew-in, it's a process. So at this point, my arms, like, I just wanted to, like, try to speed the process up. So I was like, okay, let me try to take down two braids at a time. But then my arm started kind of, like, hurting again. And I was just like, forget it. I'm just going to try to just take my time with the process again. You don't want to rush it, especially taking down your braids. Because I did start to kind of get frustrated. And I was just like, forget it. But I'm like, bro, I can't just be saying forget it, because this my hair. This ain't the weave no more. This my hair. So you gotta make sure you're taking your time with your hair. When you detangling your hair, I would suggest detangling with your fingers first. And what I like to do once I finish completely taking out my braids, y'all, is I like to finger detangle my hair, and I like to spray water, and I put some Cantu leave-in conditioner on my hair. So I spray it with water, and then I put the Cantu conditioner on my hair, and that makes my hair a lot more softer and a lot more easier to manage. So I run my fingers through it first, gently, making sure that I'm not ripping all of my hair out, And then once I do that, I take a wide tooth comb and then I use the comb to comb through it. So finally, honey, I am done. I've taken all these braids out my daggone head. And now I'm just going to I thought I took all these braids out, honey. Don't you hate when you get to the end, you start fluffing your hair to find that you got another little braid left. So I got to take that little last braid out, honey. And then I am finally done. And this is my little puff, y'all. I'm going to do a quick length check with y'all. See how long my little hair done got a little bit. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Also, remember to follow your girl on Instagram at Quoia_Renae. You see that, what is it called? Instagram handle at the top. Follow it, honey. Follow it and leave a comment. I love y'all. Bye.